Welcome back, everyone, to Wednesday Night Lights, our 14th episode of Season 2. Luke Martin alongside Sebastian Dimter. Big show. I mean, not a lot of huge bowl games have happened since we were last on here, but a lot coming up.
Yeah,
for this sure. This is our Christmas episode, technically.
Yep.
Should have brought the Santa hats, but whatever. You live and you learn. So I think let's just start NFL recap.
Yeah.
I think that's the best way to do this.
Yeah.
And we'll go by... Last Thursday, day after our last recording, the Chargers.
Wow.
The Chargers got beat so bad they fired their GM and Brandon Staley.
They finally did it.
Yeah, they finally did. It's been a long time coming.
I consider that a win.
Yeah.
The
guys they replaced. Yeah. Giff Smith is the interim head coach.
Giff Smith. Okay.
And then they're...
Don't they still have Kellen Moore?
Yeah. Oh. they replaced Brandon Staley and whoever their GM was with Giff Smith and JoJo Wooden. So
there we go.
I mean, that's all name.
I'll fix it right there.
I'm definitely off to a hot start for the Chargers. But yeah, that's a. I mean, when we say like, oh, they're gonna charger it up this week, like that was.
Yeah.
That was some chargering, letting up 63 to the Raiders.
And you know what the worst part is? Ethan Stick wasn't great. I don't think he was that bad. I don't know. Like, I don't think he was terrible. That's the thing.
Yeah, I mean that game was so long ago, I've kind of, like, removed it from my memory. But, like...
Think about it.
Yeah.
Keenan Allen, Mike Williams.
Yeah, yeah.
That hurts. And then Austin Eckler's just falling off a cliff. Let me just say that real quick.
I mean, I've had the long-standing take, and like last year in the playoff game, it proved it to me. If fantasy football wasn't a thing, Austin Eckler would not be praised as highly as he is.
But he's always been like a pretty good.
I disagree. I strongly disagree.
Wow.
I think he's a PPR merchant.
Yeah. No. Well. Okay. He might not. He never was like a fantastic runner, but his receiving presence is maybe just as good as McCaffrey's.
No.
Like, you know, give him his two prime years where Austin Eckler was a star running back.
That's 2 years. What, like 2019?
But like, I'm saying, like, during that span, you could say he was, I mean, obviously it was McCaffrey, but he's right there for one of the best receiving backs in the league.
I don't know. Bottom line, though, Chargers cleaning house. That's a good start.
Shout out Aiden O'Connell.
Yeah, Aiden O'Connell. Do you think the Raiders... hold on to Antonio Pierce?
I think they should.
I think they should. I think they messed up by letting Bisaccia walk.
Yeah, I think they learned a lesson.
But also, like, this might be a Linsanity run from Pierce because his last coaching job was as, like, a high school coach where they went, like, they had, like, back-to-back three-win seasons. He drove them into the ground. So, like, I mean, I don't know.
It's not how you start. It's how you finish.
Okay.
I always say. So, I have faith.
I'm not the most confident with the Raiders, but then again, like, it's the Raiders. Who cares? Like, they have a long way up. I still think that they, like, going forward, if Herbert remains in LA, I think the Raiders are going to be stuck at the bottom of that division for quite some time.
But I do think the Raiders are close. I think, like, they have guys.
Yeah, I think they kind of found a diamond in the rough with Aiden O'Connell. Like, it's possible. It's possible that he's their guy. I don't see why they would go after a quarterback.
Star running back in Jacobs, star wide receiver Davante Adams. Jacoby Myers is pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, defensively, you have Max Crosby.
Max Crosby's a difference maker. If they can surround him with more guys on the defense, like, that's a legitimate, like, scary.
They're close.
Defense. That can test the Chiefs, I think.
If Aiden O'Connell could, like, just surpass, like, any expectation he has. They could be a pretty good team.
I think Aiden O'Connell has turned out to be what I thought David Blau would be.
I see.
Yeah, I thought David Blau would be this gunslinger. I thought he was going to be a sleeper, step up big in the pros. But no, Aiden O'Connell has definitely exceeded expectations. He's been great.
For sure.
So next game, why not? This has been the year of the backup quarterbacks. It's a bad time for Chase Daniel to retire.
Yeah.
Because we had Jake Browning versus Nick Mullins in a thriller.
Who would have thought?
It was... No. Let me rephrase. It was three mediocre quarters of football where it's like, hey, like, at least football's on. Mm-hmm. It's a Saturday. There's no college football. At least we have this. And then fourth quarter in overtime was
It was amazing.
That was top notch. I think that was by far the best game of that day.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. Yeah.
Jake Browning, of course, coming with the win. Jake Browning, I have the take. He plays the way that people think Brock Purdy plays.
I don't disagree with that.
Yeah, hold on.
They play very.
I wish AWS would do this for every game. Let me see if they updated it.
Hot take really quick. I think the Vikings are going to miss the playoffs.
Yeah.
I said this a few weeks ago.
I mean, you know my take. We can mull about with that.
Wait, what was your? I forgot about that.
Damn. They only have his one from Jacksonville. Okay. But I mean, we can go off of that game. He played great against Jacksonville, but one of his 37 attempts. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 22 of his 37 attempts were inside 5 yards.
Wow.
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 were behind the line of scrimmage of those 22.
Wow.
He plays the way that people are like, yeah, Brock Purdy's just a dump off merchant. Zach Taylor, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Zach Taylor. That this was a elite coaching job by Zach Taylor, I'd say.
I'd say so.
I'm not saying that Joe Burrow's system at all, but we got to give some credit to Taylor. That was nice, okay?
Yeah.
I mean, the book's out on this Vikings defense. We know Brian Flores blitzes a unproportionate amount to the league, but this was unexpected. I did not think Browning would play as well as he did in this game. I mean, there were very few mistakes. And on the other side, I mean, Nick Mullins didn't play too bad. He just had that one throw where it was the shortest interception of all time. I think it literally traveled 1 foot.
Yeah.
And then after the play, he's like going to the ref. He's like, no, I threw it. Like, that wasn't a fumble. And they're like, dude, like, you handed it to him. But yeah, that game, did not expect to be talking about it on the show. But I mean, here we are. Like, that was nice.
Yeah.
And I think Jake Browning is kind of slowly earning his
flowers.
No, not necessarily that, but I think he's gonna earn his spot as like a backup / third string for the next couple,
so like
5 or so years.
Tyson Bagent scenario.
No, because Tyson Bagent was D2. Jake Browning was one of the most highly touted recruits.
He was
not coming out of college, but going into college.
He was amazing.
Very highly rated.
He was amazing in Washington.
Yeah, he got a Heisman invite, I think.
Yeah.
Or maybe he was like top 10 finisher.
No, whatever. Top 10, yeah.
I'm sure, yeah, at least top 10.
Yeah.
But he was great in Washington. The Steelers.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that. I know we're pro-Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
We like Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Steelers are bad. And like for the longest time, I've always been like, hey, Mike Tomlin's never finished below 500. And Steelers fans for a long time have been like, this should not be celebrated. We're celebrating mediocrity.
Mm-hmm.
I used to think they're ungrateful. That they have a point. They have a point. And you can be like, oh, like it's not their fault. They had Matt Canada at the beginning of the year. Kenny Pickett and Mitch Trubisky are their quarterbacks. I mean, they're moving on to Mason Rudolph now. It's bad. It's real bad. George Pickens is probably top 5 diva wide receiver. And I love diva wide receivers. You do too. Antonio Brown's one of your favorite all-time players on the field. So, I mean, we're pro diva wide receiver. George Pickens is up there, though, for sure.
Could I put George Pickens in the bust category?
It's going to be hard to, because he does have that one catch. Personally?
Yeah, but like...
Personally?
You never... Like,
where do you get drafted?
Second round.
Second round? I don't think he's a second round bust. If he was like before Quentin Johnston. Johnston went 21. I think that's like the cutoff.
Okay. That's fair.
Quentin Johnson's a boss.
Give him another year. I'm going to give him another year. I like giving guys chances. Give him 1 year. If he's bad, then he's a boss. I give players 2 years.
Okay.
If they're bad after 2 years, you're a boss. That's how I see it.
Yeah, but he's putting up Kadarius Toney type highlights.
I mean, I think he was actually open a lot in that Raiders game. Just to, you didn't throw it to him.
Johnson?
Yeah.
No, he was open a lot in that Raiders game, and when he got targeted.
No, he didn't drop any.
In the Raiders game?
No.
All right.
He only got two targets.
All right, we can fact check.
He only
that.
Got two targets. All right.
But regardless, back to Pickens, Steelers.
Yeah, what happened to the Steelers team? Like, I think Kenny Pickett isn't the greatest quarterback.
No, like, not at all.
They need him the most.
Yeah.
For sure.
They play like Iowa football. And they have
same colors.
They have the defense for it. But that's, you can't win games like that in the NFL.
You can't.
And we saw Shane Steichen. I think who's your coach of the year vote?
Oof. Let me get back to you on that.
Okay.
Let me
think, I think
a little bit.
It's either Steichen or Stefanski.
That's fair.
I mean, Stefanski has the most injured team in the NFL, and they're at what, 9 wins?
Yeah, give me Stefanski if they make the playoffs.
But Steichen, I could also see that if he gets the Colts into the playoffs, that's incredible with Gardner Minshew as their starter.
I think Gardner Minshew's always been a starting quarterback. I never considered Minshew as a backup.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's had some backup type games this year. That's.
Yeah, but I think he's better than Kenny Pickett.
Okay.
I think he's better than. I think he's better than Deshaun Watson. I'll go there. I think he's better than Deshaun Watson.
Right before Watson went down this year, he had a string of games where it was like, this guy is going to will the Browns into the playoffs. He goes down. It's like, all right, all hope is lost. AFC North kind of weak. And the Browns have just like kind of been getting by. They've had a resurgence. This defense is still this defense. I mean, they are elite.
My defense player of the year is
Garrett is terrifying.
He's my defense player of the year.
Yeah, I think rightfully so.
Yeah, for sure. Like,
off the top of my head, I can't think of anyone that's impacted games as well as he has.
Yeah, there's a reason why he's the number one overall pick. This is why the defense is number one.
Actually, yes. I'm gonna pull up the playoff picture for reference. Why don't you introduce our next?
All right, so Lions, big time win over the Broncos. I mean, the Broncos seem like they're having a little bit of a resurgence, but they looked like the team the first 4 weeks of the season.
I think this was a not so much loser leaves town, but this is a loser drops expectations. I don't think the Broncos can really take themselves seriously, or like Broncos fans can like in good faith be like, yeah, all we got to do is just win this game, then we get a matchup here. Like playoff wise, first round exit. I mean, as it stands right now, that win has the Lions matched up with the Vikings, and that loss has the Broncos out.
So who's in for the final couple spots for AFC?
For the AFC?
Yeah.
It's so obviously all the division leaders, and then it's 5 Browns, 6 Bengals, 7 Colts.
I think it's gonna stay like that.
Yeah, well,
I don't see.
I think the Bills and the
The Bills.
I think might be jumping the Colts, but other than that, just tough look for the Broncos. I mean, that was an ugly game.
Because like they were looking, they were looking pretty good.
Yeah, and
before that game, they were looking pretty good.
And the first quarter was good too, and then they just let the Lions go on 5 straight touchdown drives. That's at any level, you can't get away with that. USC doesn't get away with that.
I think the biggest
can't get away with that in the NFL.
The biggest thing with the Broncos, the reason why they were winning games, was because that defense came back to life. This was the defense that we saw the first 4 weeks. That's how I see it, and that's why they lost.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's a great take, actually. Yeah.
They were awful.
I don't really have. There's not much else to say. Like the Broncos looked atrociously bad. The Lions stepped up their game.
NFC North.
I think they've broken the cold streak. And like as much as we're like, oh, like the Broncos are frauds, blah 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 blah. This is still like a decent Broncos team. The Lions look great.
Yep.
They got their get back. They get the Vikings this week. I think they play a team in between, and then they get the Vikings again to close, if I'm not mistaken. But that's a good spot. I don't see them losing to the Vikings. I think they're just gonna bounce the Vikings from the playoffs as it is. Which opens up a spot for, I mean, we'll talk about them later, but the Seattle Seahawks.
The Bears.
Brother. 5-9. You gotta let
give
it go.
Give me that 1% chance. I'll take it.
It's the picture.
I ain't hear no bell.
Been ringing. It's the picture of the Gucci backpack with like it's like torn to shreds, and it's like you gotta let it go, bro. It's over. Next game. Perfect transition. Bears. Let's talk about that.
They lost in the only way the Bears could.
We caused 3 turnovers and lost.
I blame this loss on Luke Getsy. I don't blame anybody.
Yeah, no, I think that's the best person.
I hate
to blame it on.
I have a problem with the media. I have a big problem with
the media. You're just now finding this out, the Chicago media is.
With Justin Fields, yeah. I have a big problem with the media.
Yeah.
This was not his fault. You can't put the loss on Justin Fields.
Yeah, there's the Tanyan drop.
I don't know, right here.
There's basket. The Tanyan drop. There was the Darnell Mooney drop.
Right here, basket.
And there's the
Tyler Scott drop. You should have caught that ball.
Yeah, and there's the play calling late. I don't know. I really don't know anymore.
Another thing no one's talking about, the running game has been terrible.
Yeah, yeah.
These last 2 weeks, it's been really bad. They've been winning games, but it's been bad.
Yeah, I'm just putting this out there. This is the worst fantasy football season I've ever had. I'm signing Deontay Foreman for the playoffs.
Okay.
I think. See, what scares me is all the Bears running backs. Not to get into fantasy. No one cares about your fantasy team. We're aware. All the Bears running backs, it's like they're all projected like
the same amount.
It's similar amounts where it's like this running back room is not doing that. Like that just tells me that ESPN doesn't know what the Bears. I don't even think Luke Getsy knows what the Bears have planned this week. It's a sad state of affairs. The Bears just got to move on. And I've been so anti Caleb Williams all year, saying Bears better not draft him. If we have the number one pick, trade it away. All I want is Marvin Harrison Jr.
Don't say it.
I'm going to backtrack a little. Think about it this way. Justin Fields, what? We have to pay him this year if we keep him, right?
Yeah, but we wouldn't have to pay him that much this year.
Oh, this is just his fifth-year option?
Yep.
Okay. We're going to have to pay him more than Caleb Williams. That's a fact. Caleb Williams resets our clock. He resets our window.
Field is going
to
be...
That's the thing. I don't think he's an upgrade. I think it's a lateral move. But he does reset our clock. And that is super valuable. And I really don't know. Another thing, the Panthers might start winning games and screw us over. So I don't even think Caleb's a lock. If we draft Drake May again, just the fact of North Carolina quarterback pick number 2,
That is a nightmare scenario.
That would send me into a spiral. I like Drake May. I think he's great. I think he might end up being the best quarterback in this class, but no, it's going to be Jaden Daniels. Jaden Daniels he's getting overlooked. He's going to get drafted late. He's Lamar Jackson again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's perfect. That's perfectly worded. That's the exact that's going to happen. He's drafted like 30th.
I just hope he doesn't go to the Vikings. That's my only thing.
Yeah.
Back to Fields. Yeah. This conversation needs to be had. Fields.
Because, like, okay, here's the thing.
I don't know what direction we're going in.
Marvin Harrison is...
generational.
I've never seen a wide receiver like him. Really fat.
I would settle for Neighbors, though. I think if Neighbors is the participation trophy in the race for Marvin Harrison Jr.,
I'm more than happy.
I'm okay with it. But, I want Marvin Harrison Jr. on the team so bad.
Like I said, I mean... Fields is winning this. I think Fields is winning the Bears some games here. This hasn't really been the case.
Right.
I think if you say last year, that wasn't really the case. Or it was, but Luke Getsy is just really bad.
Yeah, yeah.
I think
the Bears are no doubt going to go in a different direction.
And like,
at least with OC and DC, I don't know if we hold on to Flus or not. I think ideal scenario, we find a new offensive coordinator, maybe some up-and-coming spunky quarterbacks coach out there, someone that knows how to develop a mobile quarterback. Because, I mean, that is the future of this team. It's whether it's Fields or it's Williams. We're going to have a guy that can run the ball and throw it as well. Demote Flus to defensive coordinator and then bring in...
Ideally
Harbaugh, but it's a coin toss. I've been very gung-ho about Harbaugh. I don't know if he's going to leave Michigan.
I've been very high on Harbaugh and Ben Johnson. I like both of them a lot.
Yeah, I think Ben Johnson would be great too.
And I also think the Bears need to... Do we maybe let Khalil Herbert and Dante Foreman go?
Yeah, yeah. I think running backs are very replaceable. We can get a UDFA. I mean, look at Tyjae Spears. What round did he go?
He was actually a third rounder.
Oh, he's a third rounder? Okay. Yeah. Okay. Never mind.
But very late third round. He's like last.
But yeah, like you don't have to draft a running back. There's plenty of UDFA running backs out there that can make a difference.
Yeah.
Running backs are, it's all luck drafting a running back, really.
Yeah.
Because you got guys like Trent Richardson and Najee Harris, who someone on Twitter said that Najee Harris looks like Anne Hathaway, and I can't get that out of my head. Anyways, you got guys like that who can't really see the field that well, and then you got undrafted guys that do all the dirty work, get it done, and running backs, you don't want to pay a running back. Like, everyone knows that's the formula to winning a Super Bowl. I'm totally okay with moving on from those two.
Yeah. I mean, my only takeaway with this, I just think the Bears are so close. Like, I'm a big believer in this Bears team. Yeah. This defense has been amazing.
Yeah, no, defense has stepped it up since our defensive coordinator mysteriously disappeared. It's been good, and that's because Flus is a defensive head coach, and he's our acting coordinator now. So
yeah, no,
makes sense.
Montez Sweat, shout out to him because he's been just
Poles was in his bag. We got the job done. Sweat loves Chicago.
Yeah, we paid him.
Yeah,
people were saying we overpaid. We did not overpay.
We did not overpay. Yeah,
no, we did not.
So
my takeaway.
Yeah,
draft Harrison, Key Fields. We're very close to being a very good team.
Yeah. A lot of small changes. I think the roster's fine.
Yeah.
But.
And get rid of Darnell Mooney.
Yeah, trade him.
Yeah, trade him.
Trade him. Okay, I think he's got some stock to him. But offensive coaching changes
is a huge point of emphasis.
Marvin Harrison Jr. bust. That's really all it is. Those are my two keys for the Bears this offseason. Because I know you're still holding on to hope the season's over.
Yeah, it is, yeah. but you know.
Panthers.
Yeah.
Panthers.
Congrats.
The get-in price for the Panthers was 45 cents.
Yep, I did see that.
And they beat the Saints.
Falcons.
I don't know why. Saints played the Giants. Tommy DeVito's agent is so Italian. that guy's the best. He got into the Italian sports
Hall of Fame.
And then he wore this like vibrant green suit with a signature fedora again on the sideline. That guy rocks.
And he used to play football too.
Yeah, he played a wide receiver at Marist.
Yep.
Beast. Not our.
Yeah.
Like Marist College and Poker. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Panthers. Nice, but not nice. We don't support that. We don't want the Panthers winning any more games. Well, like, you had your fun. Please lose out.
Well, you could beat the Packers. I'm okay with that. They'll still be in the first spot.
Yeah, but it's a small cushion, dude. I just don't want
to see the Packers in the playoffs. Okay, Jordan loves.
They're not making them.
Jordan loves.
And if they do, they'll get embarrassed again.
Like, Jordan loves.
See what Baker Mayfield did to that defense?
Yeah.
Okay, wait. We'll talk about this in a sec. Texans win with Case Keenum as their starter.
Hey, legend. I love Case Keenum. Love Case Keenum.
Yeah, I'm gonna just pretend all my Will Levis takes didn't happen from last week. I'm gonna just chill on that for a sec.
Okay. Yeah. I mean,
I thought, in my defense, I thought Derrick Henry would dominate this game.
Derrick Henry's fallen off a cliff.
He did nothing. Yeah.
I love Derrick Henry.
And running backs age like that. So I'm not blaming him for anything. But yeah, running backs age, and we're seeing it firsthand.
I love Derrick. Like Derrick.
Which.
Legitimately, he was my favorite player like a couple years ago.
Yeah, I hate to interrupt, but this makes Raheem Mostert so much more impressive. That man is like 32, having the best season of his life.
He's so fast. Still.
He's so fast. Yeah, you don't see that. You really don't see running backs sprout up in the way he has. So like, yeah, Mike McDaniels, or is it Mike McDaniel?
McDaniel.
Mike McDaniel. Okay. Now it's not happening anymore, but we used to have Josh McDaniels and Mike McDaniel, one of the best, one of the worst. same last name, mix them up, whatever. But the Texans won't. That's the moral of the story. Like, this team
that was big
can win without Tank Dell. They can win without CJ Stroud. Who else was missing? Hold on.
Was Collins out?
Yes, he was. And Damian Pierce has been absent this entire season.
Yeah.
I drafted him in fantasy, which...
Yeah, I don't know
why. This is very out of character for me to bring up fantasy twice, but I'm stressing. Damian Pierce, what's happening?
He just can't run the ball more than, like, 2 yards.
What it seems like, yeah.
I'm looking at his numbers, like... 2 yards, 2 yards, 2 yards, two
it's,
yards. Like,
it's ugly, and I hate to see it, but they are somehow winning games even without that. So.
Well, Singletary stepped up.
I know. But I mean, going into the year, if you're like, all right, yeah, it's Pierce and Singletary, I'm like, all right, Pierce is gonna.
Yeah, because Pierce is really good.
Is gonna pick up the slack for where Singletary leaves off, and it's been quite the opposite. Yeah. Bills.
I did not see this one coming.
Yeah, I picked the Bills to win. I didn't think it would be that close, or I didn't think it would be this big of a blowout. Josh Allen threw, what, he was 7 of 15 with less than 100 yards.
Why does he look like 2018 Mahomes 1 week, and then like...
You're talking about Allen?
Yeah.
They didn't need him. It was he was JJ against he was JJ against Penn State.
I mean, he still played a good game, I think.
Well, yeah, JJ played a good game against Penn State.
That's true.
Yeah.
James Cook was
okay. They didn't need him. James Cook was averaging, I think, like 8 yards a carry.
Yeah.
On
the Cowboys defense.
And then their backup running back was averaging like 7. And then Allen was averaging like 4. Like, these guys just ran all over them. They didn't need to throw the ball at all. Josh Allen said it pretty well. He was like, yeah, I feel like the kid in the class project that didn't do anything still got an A. Like, they dominated.
Yeah.
They dominated.
I'm proud to say this.
They killed him. Oh, and
Dak's Linsanity run is over.
Okay, yeah.
Thank God.
See, if Dak wasn't the quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys, he'd be one of the most universally loved players.
Yeah, probably. Like, I just like dissing on the Cowboys. I like Dak.
If Dak Prescott wasn't the quarterback for the most hated team in the league, and I mean, he has been, and he's stood in that position for so long. I mean, he's by far the most likable guy off the field out of every quarterback in the league right now. He's not like outgoing or funny, but I think he's got like the most... Yeah, like he's got like an emotional story, and people hate on him just because he's the Cowboys quarterback. Hand up, me included. But yeah, I think we should take a step back and realize like it's more than football. But yeah, the Cowboys, they have a game this week. Hold on. Dolphins, Cowboys, loser of this game is dead. Super Bowl hopes, throw them out. They're done. You're not.
These are both fraudulent teams.
I think they're fraud adjacent. The loser's
a okay.
Yeah. The loser's a fraud. And you can be good and be a fraud. Fraud doesn't mean you're bad. It just means you're not who you say you were.
Yeah.
And the loser of this game, Dolphins, Cowboys, we'll talk about that in a sec. The Ravens. Ravens dominated. I don't really got to say much.
I say this every week. Lamar Jackson deserves more MVP recognition.
Yeah.
He's been really good.
Especially the Keaton Mitchell injury. Brutal. Yeah.
Oh, that was ugly.
Yeah. It was Willis McGahee. That was bad.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Ravens. I think this week, Monday Night Football, which is that's Christmas.
Game of the year.
Christmas.
Game of the year.
On Christmas.
Is it?
Yeah, the Monday Night Football game on Christmas is a Super Bowl preview. I mean, those are the two best teams right now. Those are the two best teams like a month and a half ago or whatever.
Hey, sidetrack. Have you seen the little conspiracy theory where it's like the Super Bowl colors? Yeah. It's literally the Ravens.
It's purple and red. Right?
Yeah.
People were saying going into the year, they're like, oh, it's going to be, they were saying either Vikings Chiefs or Ravens Niners. It's looking like Ravens Niners. Yeah. So that's crazy. See, like the whole like Arian Foster, like NFL scripted thing, like that was funny. But if it turns out being Ravens Niners, I think the tinfoil hats online have, they might have a little leeway with that conspiracy. Drew Lock. Let's talk about Drew Lock for a quick second and then get into our picks.
Eagles are...
They're bad. They're not winning the Super Bowl. They are done.
Yeah.
That was a must win for them, I think.
Yeah.
You lose a must win, your season's over.
I mean, what? I mean, Hurts, okay. I was always saying Hurts is MVP just because, like,
three quarterbacks.
The record.
Three quarterbacks have 17 turnovers. Can you name them?
17, like, this year?
Yes.
Well, Hurts.
He's one of them, yeah.
Okay. Ooh, that's not very easy.
No, it's not. One of them you'd expect, the other one.
Mahomes?
No.
Whoa, really?
No.
He's at least leading, like, picks, though. Doesn't he?
He might. I don't know. He doesn't.
I'm actually surprised.
But 17 is pretty extreme.
This isn't. I gotta, like.
They both have the same name. That's your hint.
Same name.
Yeah. Ooh.
Same name.
All right, we don't have a lot of time. It's Josh Allen and Josh Dobbs.
Josh Dobbs has 17 turnovers.
17 turnovers.
Oh, boy. How is this guy so good for 2 weeks? I don't get it.
He's only good when he doesn't know the names.
Sure.
The names of the guy who he's under center with and the guy that he's throwing to. But yeah, okay, Drew Lock, though.
Yeah.
Not a great game, but you only need that last drive.
I mean, you've been saying it. He's better than Geno Smith.
We've been saying it.
He's better than
Geno
Smith.
It for so long. Hold on.
Yep. Just like that.
Yeah. So like Tom Herman is the coach of a 4-8 Florida Atlantic team, and Drew Lock just won Monday Night Football against a team that was in the Super Bowl last year. So who really won that game? That's all I'm saying. Mizzou note, because we're not going to have time to talk portal at the end. Mizzou is... Eli Drinkwitz is lights out in the transfer portal right now.
So is Marcus Freeman.
It's good to be us. Let's just say that. It is good to be us.
Name your top three transfers, really quick. Your top three guys you've gotten.
Top three guys? Oh, it was the...
Here, I'll name mine real quick.
Yeah, go for it.
We got Riley Leonard. Talked about it last week a little bit. I'm not too crazy on it, but we'll see how that works. We got Chris Mitchell from FAU. That's going to be huge. He is amazing. And then we have Biax Collins from Clemson. Wide receiver.
Okay.
So offense is looking good.
So Darius Smith, Georgia linebacker.
Okay.
That was a big one. We got, what's the guy's name? Caden Green.
Caden Green. Oh.
Tackle. Okay. True freshman tackle from Oklahoma. Oklahoma lost their entire offensive line. So
they lost everybody.
And that's one of Mizzou's locked opponents every year. So
yeah, that's good.
That's nice. And then the third, it was what's his name? The running back from Georgia State. I'm blanking on the name, though.
You got Marcus Carroll? Georgia State?
Yeah.
Marcus Carroll?
Yeah, Marcus Carroll.
No way.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, and Toriano Pride.
Marcus Carroll's good. I had him on my... me and Luke did like a...
Oh, yeah.
Fantasy college.
Yeah, we got Marcus Carroll. Yeah, I was blanking on the name. Toriano Pride, too. We got the number one corner.
Wow.
We have a young offensive tackle who's already played in 5 games. We have a guy who played for Georgia, okay? We're flipping the script. It's no more Dom Lavette leaving. We get Darius Smith. So, and obviously Williams Nwaneri. Ryan Wingo is being suspicious. He might be coming back.
Yeah, I did see that.
He's being,
mm-hmm.
I don't know, we'll see. It's a good day to be, it's a good time to be a Missouri Tiger.
M-I-Z.
Z-O-U. And, yeah, I mean, can we just talk about Drew Lock? Let's talk about James Bradbury. James Bradbury got targeted on every single play on that 93-yard drive.
Wow. Okay.
Every single play. JSN had a great snag. Bit of an overthrow by Drew Lock, but, you know, big-time players make big-time plays.
He's made that catch before. Rose Bowl.
Against Utah? Yeah. Yeah. But, yeah, it's nice to see Drew Lock. I hope they don't.
Also, they won because they used DK Metcalf. I'm just saying.
Yeah, yeah.
Really think about it.
Noah Fant and DK Metcalf.
Every time they threw to DK Metcalf, they scored a touchdown.
DK Metcalf had like 20 yards going into that last drive, and then he got like another like 50 on the drive. it was great.
Great.
It was the best 5. All right, let's do pick 'em. Bears Cardinals.
Don't think about this.
The Bears and Cardinals. Okay, I'm going to pick the Bears because I want the Bears to win. I'm going to be cheering for the Bears. I want the Bears to win.
It's Christmas. Christmas at Soldier Field is, it's It's different.
I think it's Christmas Eve, but yeah.
Same thing.
Christmas Eve at Soldier Field, I was there last year. It's not different. We for a day, we were, what's it, Highmark, we were Highmark Stadium West. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it was all Bills. It was all Bills.
Yeah, give me the Bears, you know.
I like the Bears here.
You know, that 1% chance to make the playoffs starts right now.
No. I disagree with that, I think.
Although the Cardinals...
Kyler Murray worries me, but this Bears defense has been great, and I do think he can be a little turnover prone at times, which...
The only way the Cardinals win this game is if Trey McBride catches 13 balls.
Yeah, Trey McBride's great.
He might be the best tight end in the league right now. That's my hot take. He's amazing.
I don't know. I Kelsey's intangible impact.
He hasn't been really good.
Yeah, but he makes guys open. It's just those guys are letting the ball go through their hands. That's the only difference.
But stats-wise, like the last few
weeks. Oh, yeah, stats.
Trey McBride's by far been the best.
Yeah, for sure. Texans-Browns, we're on the same side here, but this one makes me think because the Browns had a tough game last week. They played bad. Texans exceeded expectations, but do we really trust Case Keenum against that? Or is CJ Stroud back?
I think CJ will.
Okay, if CJ's back, this game is not much of a one to think about. But quite the question's there.
Yeah, if CJ plays, yeah. But if not, give me the Browns.
So. Okay. Yeah, Flacco didn't play.
Oh, really quick.
Flacco didn't play too great.
He still hasn't practiced yet.
Stroud. Was it a concussion?
It's concussion.
That's a tough look. I'm going to be honest. That's tough.
I'm going to leave it at that. If Stroud plays, give me Houston. If he doesn't, give me Browns.
Okay. I'm going to stick with Houston no matter what. This is crunch time games. I think D'Amico Ryans is going to get his guys up.
Okay.
Dolphins, Cowboys, I alluded to it earlier. Loser. It's a loser leaves town. I mean, technically, the Cowboys already clinched a playoff spot, and technically the Dolphins are the second best team in their conference right now. But the loser's done. The loser of this game is done. And I don't know.
It's tough because both of these teams have been not so great against good teams, I'd say. Yeah. Cowboys have been a little bit better, I'd say. But at some point, the Dolphins are going to play well. This is the game.
This is going to be... I think it will be a close game, though.
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe a little low scoring, too.
Yeah.
I could... Yeah, but then there's...
No, it's going to be a high scoring game.
Then there's Tyreek Hill. It's like, you can't...
The MVP, if you...
You can't do much about that. Yeah, if Tyreek Hill gets 2,000 yards, he should be MVP. No doubt.
Yeah, no doubt. I agree.
And then game of the year, Niners-Ravens.
I've never struggled with a pick this much.
So, the last 7 Monday Night Football games, the underdog has won outright. And the Ravens open as a 5.5-point underdog.
Lamar Jackson and Brock Purdy are my top two MVPs.
Now, that's crazy.
No, it's not crazy. Brock Purdy's been really good. You can't deny Brock Purdy's been...
No, I'm not denying he's been good, but I think...
Who's better? I mean, Tyreek Hill's right
there. Tyreek Hill's my one. And Lamar Jackson too.
I only say those two because it's a quarterback's award. It's a quarterback's award.
Christian McCaffrey. Unfortunately. Christian McCaffrey 3.
I agree.
Yeah. Real ball knowers are putting Trent Williams as their 3, but I don't think that's gonna happen. But yeah, go for it. I got the Niners here.
Give me the Ravens.
Okay.
Lamar Jackson's
getting a little disagreement. Healthy debate. Yeah.
Give me Lamar.
Okay. I like that. I respect
They've been
that
playing too. Amazing in primetime.
And it
playing in Jacksonville, not easy.
Yeah.
And they just dominated.
Oh man, I wish I wrote down the stat. They did a blind resume today on PMT. Through 48 games, quarterback A is 20-28, quarterback B is 19-29. Touchdown to interception ratio is off by 2 in quarterback A's favor. What else? Very similar completion percentage. And quarterback B has way more rushing yards. There was another. But, I mean, they're basically identical stats.
And who are those guys?
Trevor Lawrence is A and Daniel Jones is B. So.
But Trevor Lawrence, you know, he wins games.
20 and 28.
Well, Urban Meyer was his coach.
Okay. Fair. Recently, yeah. though, I don't know. It's definitely a point of concern.
The Giants had the flukiest season I've ever seen last year.
I mean, they're first in their division right now, but the Colts are on their tail. Texans are on their tail.
I don't think they win the division.
The Titans are in last place in the conference right now.
Wow. And they have the same record as the Bears.
No, that's false. They are in 14th. The NFL website has it listed backwards. The Patriots are way worse.
Yeah, okay. That's what I was saying. Okay. Yeah, there's no way.
That confused me for a second. So, but yeah, something to think about.
So, bowl talk?
Yeah, let's do talk it. Bowls, playoffs. I mean, it's... Okay, to be fair, no bowl game is important anymore.
I mean...
Because the only team actually playing their starters is, like, Missouri. Because all their starters are young, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Miami Rutgers. We'll start there.
I mean, I'm not trying to hate on Rutgers, but I think Miami's more talented squad.
1-point favorite.
Give me Miami. They don't have Van Dyke, but give me Miami.
It's all Rutgers. It's all Rutgers.
No.
Greg Schiano's going to have his guys bought in. Cristobal doesn't know anything about grit.
Sorry, they had their little insanity run in the beginning of the year, and they're like 6-1. That's gone.
Yeah, they had the run where ESPN was being like, "Yeah, Ohio State's number one in the country. They have a quality win over Rutgers." it's like, all right, if you say so. I like Rutgers in this game though.
Yeah.
Kansas State, North Carolina State. North Carolina State is one of the most boring teams to watch, and Kansas State is a little bit better. So I'm taking the Wildcats here, but not very confidently. Yeah,
this isn't a great
game. This game should be low scoring in theory, because I do think Will Howard's in the transfer portal and he's an X factor.
Will Howard, by the way, is probably gonna go to USC.
You think
that's what I'm hearing?
That would be interesting because they are going to be awful. They're gonna be awful.
Yeah, and that's their first year in the Big Ten too, so they're gonna have a hard time.
Yeah. Will Howard against like Minnesota and Nebraska.
Will Howard versus Will Howard versus Luke Altmaier. The ages.
I really wish they kept divisions, and it was like, ew. Well, let me look this up. Next game.
Oklahoma, Arizona. You already know who I'm going with. Come on.
Yeah, me too. Arizona. Which, Arizona's weird. Their nickname's the Wildcats, but on their field it says Bear Down.
That's really weird.
It is a little weird, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about that. I wish they would keep the divisions in the Big Ten, and it would be...
Oh, me too.
The Big Ten West would be Washington, Oregon, UCLA, USC. Okay?
Okay.
Combine that with Nebraska, Minnesota, Iowa, Wisconsin.
Illinois.
You think Illinois? And that'd be what? 9 teams?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, but do you do Northwestern Illinois? That's the debate. I think if you're Illinois, you'd rather play in that division.
Yeah. Me too.
I mean, like,
yeah, because
recruiting wise, USC probably has the highest ceiling of any. Well, no, Ohio State and Michigan are 1 and 2, and then USC is probably like 2A.
Probably.
But yeah, that's. I wish they would do that instead of going pods.
Yeah, I don't like that.
It'd be very funny to see UCLA and Iowa like build a rivalry. Like that's not something you see. That game next year. I don't know if they play next year, but if they do, that game's gonna be like.
That game's gonna be terrible. They don't have
10-0.
That game's gonna be awful.
Because UCLA is losing everybody. Iowa is doing their thing. They're cruising.
They're still bad.
I love Iowa football. They are.
No, I don't.
Yeah,
I'm a big time Iowa football hater.
Yeah.
I hate it. Score points. Score points. Make the game enjoyable to watch.
Did you apply for the job?
For
offense coordinator at Iowa.
Oh, I should.
They have the offensive coordinator job
open. Oh, I did see that.
Yeah.
On Google, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I mean, we're not old enough, but I think they'd make an exception.
Yeah, I think so.
If you just put in like a resume of all your like NCAA.
You could be quarterback's coach, I'll be a receivers coach.
Yeah, that'd be great for me to try to explain to Cade McNamara like why his progressions are wrong. that'd be a sight to see. Yeah. Clemson and Kentucky.
Clemson.
See, Clemson is losing all their guys as well.
But they still have, I mean, Cade.
But Kentucky's not good.
Yeah,
exactly. I think that's how when I was picking this game, that's what it came down to for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Clemson's a 5-point favorite. I like that too. Notre Dame, Oregon State.
Notre Dame.
You probably know the line and every single thing on here.
Oregon State is playing the third string quarterback.
Okay. So whatever Notre Dame is.
Sam Hartman is not playing in this bowl game.
It's understandable.
Neither is Audric Esmig.
Is Sam Hartman going to get drafted?
He'll probably be like a 6th round pick. Okay. That's what I'm thinking. Okay. But he should get drafted. I think he's NFL caliber.
I think he looks like a guy you see wearing a hat on the sidelines. I close my eyes and I could totally see Sam Hartman in like a, I don't know, like a Raiders jersey.
Okay.
With like a hat and a clipboard and a headset on. Like I think that's where he peaks. He might get like a game or two.
Audric Estime is gonna be a really good player.
I think so too. I think he's a lot.
He's gonna be like Derrick Henry 2.0.
Okay.
He has that build. But give me Notre Dame, Steve Angeli. We'll see a lot because he's their backup.
Okay.
I have a lot of faith in him, so we'll see how he does.
All right. Mizzou plays Ohio State. Ohio State opened as a touchdown favorite. They are now 3-point dogs, I think.
Probably because
Kyle McCord.
See ya.
You congratulations. You are an orange.
Jeez.
But Amika Egbuka was like, yeah, actually Devin Brown's been better this whole time.
I agree. I agree. I like.
No, Devin I think Brown. I think Kyle McCord put Ohio State in the best position to win this year. He just wasn't CJ Stroud and he wasn't Justin Fields.
I love me some Devin Brown though. But
is what it is.
You already know. MIZ all the way.
Yeah.
Brady Cook.
Mizzou wins this game, I think. I think 30-13.
I think
I originally said 30-20, but I think 30-14 is probably more accurate.
Yeah.
That's
fair.
Yeah, they're gonna stomp them. Yeah. Penn State will miss. I think this is gonna be another stomping. I think Penn State is gonna obliterate them. Okay, so Jackson Dart's not playing, obviously. Spencer Sanders.
That's all I need to know.
Sanders, the backup, ready? Is not academically eligible for this game.
Yeah.
So they are on their third string. Junkins, I doubt he's playing.
Probably not.
And even if it was these two teams going head to head like week 7 this year, give me Penn State. Like,
yeah.
Penn State is a much better team, and that's gonna get proven right. The Big Ten is better than the SEC. Well, no. The top of the Big Ten is better than the SEC this year.
I'd say so.
I think Michigan, Penn State, and Ohio State all...
You forgot about Illinois.
Yeah, true. Top of the Big Ten.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Iowa. Throw Wisconsin in there. They play LSU. Jaden Daniels not playing.
You can throw in Minnesota if you want to. They made a bowl game.
That's true. They did make a bowl game. But yeah, give me Penn State.
I agree. Penn State's going to win that game.
All right, Florida State, Georgia. This is the I told you so game. Georgia's going to win by like 20.
Yeah.
Kirby Smart's mad. If they were in a different scenario and Georgia got snubbed, I think Kirby Smart would just kind of... Or if they lost earlier in the year and they like weren't really in the conversation, Kirby Smart would be like, forget it. Like, we'll reload. This team is... mad, and they are going to stick it to Florida State, and Florida State is going to be like, I mean, they don't have an excuse. They can't say, well, we don't have Jordan Travis. It's like, that was our point.
They have like Schoonmaker, right? Or what's his name? What's the backup?
I already forgot. It's been long. This is the first time I've thought about Florida State since the committee left them out.
Yeah.
Same. And I think I speak for a lot of people when I say that. Tennessee, Iowa. Now this game excites me. Iowa is going to beat them. Iowa's going to win this game. Tennessee is not. They're not good. They don't have.
They aren't good.
Tennessee does not have a good offense, and they don't have. They certainly don't have a good defense.
A lot of respect for Iowa basketball. Don't get me wrong, especially their women's team.
Correct.
I like Iowa and every other sport. I really just hate their football.
Their football team is so funny.
Passion.
They're so funny.
I don't like it.
They're so funny.
No,
you.
I don't.
If Illinois won that game, you would be singing. Iowa's praises right now that we were at.
No.
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't pick Iowa regardless.
All right. Well,
give me Tennessee here.
Okay. This way, you'll see how this plays out. It's going Iowa's way.
Deacon Hill's going to throw for 50 yards and they'll win.
See, that's the only thing. That's the only thing.
Deacon Hill. I hate it.
Okay.
Yeah, I absolutely hate it. I, I have such hatred for this football team.
Okay.
The way they play.
Undefeated Liberty, Oregon. How much does Oregon win by? I think at least 20. I think this is going to be similar to Oregon, Colorado.
I think Liberty gets off to a quick start, and then Oregon will storm right back. But they're not going to have Bo Nix, right?
Or is and they're not going to have Thompson either.
Who, the Oregon?
Yeah, he entered the portal.
Are
they going to add Gabriel and Dante Moore? Yeah. Which is crazy. They got both those guys.
Wait, if you like transfer now, can you play in the bowl game?
I think so. Yeah.
I don't think so.
No.
Because then, like,
well, hold on.
Because then Riley Leonard would play for Notre Dame probably.
Yeah.
So I don't think so.
I don't know.
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure that that's not the case. Liberty. I like Liberty. I'm gonna be honest. I really do like Liberty, but I think Oregon's still better. So.
Yeah, I like Liberty too, and I'm gonna use my liberty, my freedom of speech, to say Oregon's gonna drop 50 on them. So.
Okay.
Yeah. You like what I did there? There you go. Yeah, that's pretty good. Michigan, Bama. Year's winding down. These are the three last college pick'em games of the year. So
I know.
Enjoy it. Michigan, Bama. Michigan wins this game. I think Michigan wins this game. I'm sticking with my gut. They got it in. Okay, this Bama team has not been impressive. Even if they come out firing, even if they play perfect ball early, this Michigan team has been dominant.
They have
time and time again. And when it's all said and done with. People are going to be looking back and they're going to be like, man, the team that challenged Michigan most was Maryland. No, it was Ohio State. I think 6 points is the closest anyone's going to be able to get to Michigan.
Give me Michigan.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, There we go.
It's so tough.
It is tough.
But yeah, I was about to say, like, as a Michigan fan, it might be easier for you. Bama has looked like a different team since that South Florida game. They've looked like the Bama we know. And it's hard to pick against them because they've been so good. I don't know.
It took a good second half to get past Ole Miss and Tennessee. I don't know.
Good teams find a way to win games. That's how I see it.
And look at Michigan. Michigan didn't attempt a pass play against an elite team, a team that's going to beat up on Ole Miss, and I mean, here we are, Washington, Texas.
This is like hardest pick.
We talked about it last week. I think Washington gets out to an early start. They jump out fast. Even if they don't, Texas isn't very good at finishing games. And Quinn Ewers, I love Quinn Ewers. I think he's great. The reason I love him is because he went to Ohio State first, took $1 million in NIL, and then said, "See ya." I never intended on actually playing for Ohio State. They were the only team that would let me jump on, come to school early. Love them for that. I like Washington in this spot.
Love Washington, but I love Texas even more. Hook 'em.
Ooh. Gross.
I think, like, when I compare both offenses, Washington has a better QB. I don't know about wide receivers, but I think A.D. Mitchell and Xavier Worthy are going to have big games. I'm not sold on this Washington like defense. I think Texas wins a very close game. If Washington wins this game, I'm not shocked at all.
Okay, next time you see us, the University of Michigan will have their first national title.
That's right.
In quite some time.
Yeah.
What, 25 years?
Something like that.
Been a long time coming. So enjoy it and...
Never thought I'd
see that. The next playoffs, I think Mizzou home playoff game. It's possible.
Maybe.
We'll see.
Who knows?
That's all we got. Any closing words?
I always talk about the Illini basketball team a little bit. We're pretty good. 13th team in the nation. One of the deepest teams in the country. We got a big game against the Tigers this Friday.
Yeah.
Bragging rights game, but... hopefully next time we talk, Illinois will be a top 10 team because that's what I think they will be.
Yeah, just in case this is our last show where I have the bragging rights, we beat you by a lot last year.
Yeah.
By like 30.
Yeah, it's the guy.
We hung 90 on you.
We had a few guys that were the...
We hung 90 on you. All right, that's our show. Yeah.
Hats off, Shaw.
And we'll see you next year. Have a happy holidays, a happy new year. And
Merry Christmas.
As always, thanks for tuning in Wednesday Night Lights.